हरिः ओम्, नमस्सर्वेभ्यः.
सो फार् वि आर् स्टडिङ्ग् आन् सन्धीस्. सो वि हेव् कवर्ड् आल् स्वर सन्धीस् इन् दिस् सीरीस्. सो जनरलि वि हेव् त्री कैण्ड्स् आफ् सन्धीस्: स्वरसन्धि, व्यञ्जनसन्धि, विसर्गसन्धि. सो औट् आफ् विच् अगेन् स्वरसन्धि हेस् अगेन् सिक्स् डिफ्रेण्ट् सन्धीस्: सवर्णदीर्घसन्धि, गुणसन्धि, वृद्धिसन्धि, यनादेशसन्धि, पूर्वरूपसन्धि, यान्तावान्तादेशसन्धि. सो वि हेव् स्टडीड् आल् सिक्स् सन्धीस् अण्ड् वि आल्सो न्यू अबौट् आल् द रूल्स् आफ् दोस् सन्धीस्. सो वि आल्मोस्ट् वि कम्प्लीटेड् आल् द स्वरसन्धीस्. सो नौ देर् इस् अनदर् थिङ्ग् इन् द स्वरसन्धि आर् इन् सन्धि केटगरि कम्स् लैक् प्रकृतिभाव. So we'll in this session we'll study about what is prakriti bhava and where it is or how it is impacting or how it is used in the sandhis. So here in the prakriti bhava, what is prakriti bhava? Again, we know where all sandhi can take place. So wherever we have two letters adjacent to each other, so there is a possibility of having sandhi in that place. But in certain places, though all the sandhi rules are applicable, but still the sandhi does not take place. So wherever we don't have sandhi applied, that place or that is called as prakriti bhava. Prakriti is nature or by native, the whatever the native form of the two shabdas or two varnas, that will still remain as it is without even being applied with sandhi. So that is what we call it as prakriti bhava. So here there are few examples in this case, like Raja plus Rishihi. So here Raja ends with A, Rishi starts with Rakara. So Akara and Rakara will generally cause Guna Sandhi, but here Raja plus Rishi does not undergo any Sandhi. The same way Dadhi plus Atra. So Ikara plus Akara, again E plus A causes Enadesha Sandhi. So it should have ideally become Dadhyatra, but it doesn't undergo Sandhi. So it is just Dadhi plus Atra. And same way Kavi plus Eto, so Ikara plus Ekara, it should have undergone the Enadesha Sandhi, but still here it doesn't. Similarly Sarva plus Ete, so Akara plus Ekara, so here again Riddhis should have happened, but it doesn't. So in all these four examples, though there are possibility of having Sandhis, but still Sandhi does not take place, and this is what we call it as Prakriti Bhava. So now let us see in which all conditions this Prakriti Bhava can happen and where the Sandhi cannot take place. So now again there are couple of scenarios where prakriti bhava can happen. So first is rakara prakriti bhava and n sandhi prakriti bhava, yakara vakara lopa prakriti bhava, pluta prakriti bhava, pragrahya prakriti bhava. So like this, in these five scenarios the prakriti bhava can happen. Once this prakriti bhava happens, the sandhi cannot take place. So let's see each of these prakriti bhava categories one by one. And the first one is rakara prakriti bhava. So already we know that we already categorized all the swaras into three categories: A, B and C. A as only A and A, B as E, E, U, U, R, R, and C as A, I, O, O. The condition here is that any letter from A or B group with rakara, if they get joined, that causes the that may cause the prakriti bhava. So if that happens, the first letter from the A or B, if it is a longer vowel, that becomes shorter. So any letter from A or B category if it joins with rakara, there may be prakriti bhava optionally happening. If prakriti bhava happens, the longer vowel of the first letter becomes short vowel. So let us see some examples here. Vasanta plus rutuhu. So here vasanta ends with a and the rutu starts with rakara. So a, it belongs to a category. So a plus r, so it becomes vasanta rutu or vasanta rutu. The first form what we see is vasanta rutu. So as I said, if any letters from A or B category joins with rakara, there may be optionally prakriti bhava can happen. So in that case, we will have two forms, one with prakriti bhava, one without prakriti bhava. That means if we consider to have prakriti bhava, we will not have sandhi applied, we will just write the letters as it is. So it becomes vasanta rutuhu. If we don't consider to have prakriti bhava, then we will have sandhi applied, and here in this case we will apply guna sandhi, it becomes vasantartu. So A plus B generally causes guna sandhi, so it will be vasantartu. So like this, two forms, one with prakriti bhava, one without prakriti bhava. And why do we call this as a prakriti bhava? Though there is a possibility of undergoing the sandhi, we don't apply the sandhi here. We just use this word as it is in the statements, though they are very next to each other. So next example, Varsha plus Rutuhu. So here again Akara plus Rakara. So again there is a possibility of having Guna Sandhi, and again as per this rule we can take it as a Prakriti Bhava. If we take it as a Prakriti Bhava, if the first letter is long vowel, it becomes short vowel. So Varsha becomes Varsha plus Rutuhu. If we don't consider to have Prakriti Bhava, then it becomes Varsharthuhu. It's a regular Guna Sandhi. So like this, this is one difference. Only if we have Prakriti Bhava, we have to make it short vowel and bring both Shakara, I mean Akara and Rakara next to each other, and keep as it is without applying sandhi, and this is what we call it as prakriti bhava. And second, third example here is that vadhu plus runam. So again here vadhu plus runam. So here ukara plus rakara. So ukara is a dirgha letter, so that becomes hraswa in case if you want to have prakriti bhava. So it becomes vadhu runam, vadhu runam. In case if you want to have sandhi applied, it becomes vadvarunam, vadvarunam iti. This there will be two forms again here. The next example here is that in the vadvarunam, if we don't have the prakriti bhava, we have applied yanadesha sandhi. And the next example, pitru plus runam. So rakara plus rakara. So ideally it should have been a savarna dirgha sandhi, but as I said, A or B category with rakara becomes, there can be a chance of having prakriti bhava. In case if you have prakriti bhava, it becomes pitru runam. If we apply proper sandhi, savarna dirgha sandhi, it becomes pitronam. So this is how whatever sandhi which applies between these categories like A or B with rakara, either savarna dirgha sandhi or guna sandhi or yanadesha sandhi, in all these three cases we can have prakriti bhava. And in case of prakriti bhava, if the first vowel is longer vowel, we will make it a short vowel and keep both the letters side by side, each next to each other, and we leave it without applying sandhi. That is one form, and we apply the regular sandhi and we'll have another form. So we'll have two forms for these cases. So this is next type of prakriti bhava, where yen sandhi, wherever yen sandhi happens, there is a chance of having prakriti bhava. So as we know, yen sandhi happens between the combinations of B with any vowel. That generally causes the yen sandhi. So during, if we are applying yen sandhi, in case if you want to have a prakriti bhava, or if the author wants to have a prakriti bhava, then in that case, if the first letter is longer, then the first letter becomes shorter, and we will never apply any yanadesha, and we'll just leave as it is. And in case if we don't want to have this prakriti bhava, we will have yen sandhi applied. So examples: dadhi plus atra. So here, if we prefer to have no, if we prefer to have prakriti bhava, so it becomes dadhi atra. And if you don't want to have prakriti bhava, it becomes yanadesha sandhi. So the rupam becomes dadhyatra. And similarly, the next example, chakri plus atra. So here, ikara plus akara. So here in this case, chakri, so ikara becomes, ikara is a dirgha letter, so it becomes short vowel. So chakri plus atra, chakri atra. Otherwise, if we apply the sandhi, it becomes chakri atra. And similarly, the next example, mastu adhuna. So again here, ukara plus akara, so B plus A, it is a yanadesha sandhi. See, again, in the case of prakriti bhava, it will be just like mastu adhuna. In case of regular sandhi, it becomes mastu adhuna. And next example is janini plus avadat. So janini is ikara, avadat starts with akara. So again, in case of prakriti bhava, janini avadat. So ni atra, here the ikara becomes ikara, the rasva letter, the short vowel, plus avadat, janini avadat. And here no more sandhi applied. And in case if you want to have yanadesha sandhi, it becomes Jananyavadat. See, in all these cases, wherever we say it's a Prakriti Bhava Rupam, in all those places, there is a possibility of having Sandhi, but we don't apply it. And that is what we call it as Prakriti Bhava. So, Dadi Atra, Chakri Atra, Mastu Adhuna, Janini Avadat. So, these are the examples for this case. The next one is Ekara Vakara Lopa Prakriti Bhava. This is the third category of prakriti bhava. So again, we know that there is a yanta vanta desha sandhi, which happens in the case of C with any letters like A or B or C. Again, except A plus A or O plus A. Other than these two becomes purvarupa sandhi. Other than these, any letters from C with A and B, A, B, C category becomes yanta vanta adesha sandhi. So in case of yanta vanta adesha sandhi, A, I, O, AU, they become the second letters. So in those cases, they become the first letter, A, I, O, AU, plus A or B or C. So in these cases, A becomes I becomes I, O becomes AU, AU becomes AU. So I, AU, AU. So these are all the replacements we get at the place of A, I, O, AU. And this is what happens in the yanta vanta adesha sandhi. See, in all these replacements, whatever adeshas we get, see, in all this we have yakara or vakara. So I or I, which has yakara, and au or au, which has vakara. So yakara or vakara, it will be there. So in these cases, the yakara or vakara can be optionally dropped. So it's not mandatory, it is optional to get dropped. If at all, if they get dropped, then whatever remaining letters we have, the sandhi will not take place there. So let us see some example here. So vartate iti. So this is a sentence where the first vartate ends with ekara, iti starts with ikara. So a plus e, it causes yantavantadesha sandhi. So generally it becomes vartat plus a becomes I, vartat plus I plus iti. So vartat I iti. So if you apply regular yantavantadesha sandhi, vartayiti, this is the word. And in case if you want to drop this yakara, so as per this rule, we can drop yakara or vakara optionally. If we prefer to drop yakara, it just becomes vartata iti. Vartat plus a plus iti. It plus a becomes ta. Vartata iti. Otherwise, if you don't want to drop yakara, it becomes vartata iti. Vartata iti. Vartata iti. So these are the two forms which we will get. Similarly, the another example, tasmai plus idam. So here I will be replaced with I, and again the yakara may get dropped optionally, and if it gets dropped optionally, then it becomes tas plus a, tasma plus idam, tasma idam. Or with regular yantavantadesha sandhi, tasma idam. So these are the two possible forms. And next is balakau plus agatau. So here balak plus au becomes au. Au plus agatau. So again, if we drop vakara, we may get balaka agatau. Or if you want to have sandhi, it becomes balakavagato. So this is how we get two forms, one with prakriti bhava, one without prakriti bhava. So again here, after dropping yakara or vakara, again this is kind of eligible for having the sandhi, like vartata plus iti. But as we dropped yakara, we'll no more apply the sandhi here, and that remains as it is, and that's why we call it as prakriti bhava. So like this is a this prakriti bhava, this kind of prakriti bhava is very common in most of the shlokas. Okay, let's see few examples from the shlokas. I have taken few Gita shlokas here. So hyudhamanyuscha vikrante uttamau jayascha viryavan saubhadro draupadeyascha sarva eva maharathaha. So here sarva plus eva. So ideally it should have been sarve eva and ekara plus ekara, and ekara gets adesha of I and ekara gets dropped, and it becomes sarva eva. So this again, here sandhi does not take place, so it remains as a prakriti bhava. And the next example here is yotsya manana vekshayaham yayete atra samagataah dhatarashtrasya durbuddehe yuddhe priya chikirshavah. So here yayete, so here again yayete. So a ekara plus ekara, again ayadesha and yakara lopa, then only akara remains, and ya plus yete, and akara ekara will no more have sandhi applied there, and it form remains ya yete. And next example here is yesham arthe kankshitam no rajyam bhogaha sukhanicha ta ime vastitha yuddhe pranans tektva dhananicha. So here ta ime Again, the same example, ekara plus ikara, ekara ayadesha and yakara lopa, then akaraha avasishyate, so ta plus ime, ta ime, so no more sandhi applied, so it remains as prakriti bhava. And the next example here is, eva muktva arjunaha sankhye rathopastha upavishat visrujya sasharam chapam shoka samvigna manasaha. So here rathopastha plus upavishat. So rathopasthe upavishat. Atra sthe ekara plus ukara. And same example as before, like ayadesha, yakara lopa, akara vasishyate, anaha atahatra rathopastha upavishat. This is the final form. And though it is eligible for sandhi, it doesn't get applied. Thanks for watching this sandhi video online. Please subscribe to this channel Sanskrit.today to watch more videos like this. And share this video with your friends and interested people or group. And please post any examples of this Prakriti Bhava in the comment section below the video. And also post any comments or feedback about this session or series. And click on the like button below the video if you like this. Thank you. Thanks for watching this online. Let us meet in the next video. Dhanyavadaha.